is Diablo Lake. In the background, you can see Diablo Dam. Just below the dam, you can see an approach road. And below the dam is the bypass reach, which we'll be looking at shortly. We're now looking at Gorge Dam, the downstream side. You can see Gorge Lake in the background. The tunnel goes through the mountainside on the right. It's about 11,000 feet in length. And the bypass reach begins below the dam, and it's approximately 2.4 miles. The pooling of water you see primarily it's thought comes from leakage at the dam. And you can see an access road going up to the dam. Now looking at the bypass reach moving downstream. Canyon walls are very steep through this reach. Creates a very constricted stream channel, and the gradient is also severe. Creates, when flow is in it, extremely high velocities. We're now down at the level of the stream bed, looking again upstream at Diablo Dam.
And again, this is not the Diablo Dam, this is the Gorge Dam.
The stream bed composition is quite large throughout the area. Standing on the service road bridge. Swing downstream and give you another perspective of the bypass reach. We're now at the uphill side of the tunnel, looking down into another portion of the bypass reach. We're now just below the tunnel. Looking at the same concrete abutment we saw from above the tunnel. And looking down at a fairly well-defined pool. Even in this cold temperature and at this time of the year, there is a small amount of flow in this reach. This is perhaps a quarter mile downstream of the tunnel. Although the bypass reach is partially obscured by some alders in the foreground. You can still see basically what the channel looks like. At the tail out of this pool, it's a large rocky buildup that spills into a very narrow and constricted channel, as you'll see in a second. We've now moved downstream of the pool. Here's the rocky lip that I was talking about. We're now panning down through the base of the channel. You can see it's very narrow. Substrate is extremely large. And you can see from the sides of the rock wall that this channel has been like this for a long, long time. Still is some running water. Most of it is subterranean. We've now moved down just below the constricted channel. Riverbed is somewhat wider here, but as you can see, it's still severe habitat. See Highway 520 parallels the channel all the way. We're now panning upstream through the restricted channel. Again, just downstream of where the last shots were taken from. Good sized pool. Smaller pockets of gravel. And again, just downstream is a narrower, more severe substrate. Gradient increases quite a bit. As you can see there, again, is some water running through this particular reach. Cascades Highway running parallel. As you can see, it's cold. Some more footage of the area just below that last scene. Substrate is extremely large down here. Looking back upstream to where we had just been. More large substrate. Small amount of flow. Steep canyon wall. As you can see in the background, bridge that goes over to Gorge Powerhouse, and also represents the end of the bypass reach. You can see Skagit River flow down there. Begins a free-flowing section of the river. The videotape that you've seen is showing you approximately 60 to 70% of the actual bypass reach, most of which is very accessible from the highway. It's the Bridge of Gorge Powerhouse. Off of Ladder Creek, background on the other side of the river. This is the start of the free-flowing section of the river. We're now just a few hundred feet below Gorge Powerhouse. You can see the start of the steep slope has moved back from the river channel on both sides. Which allows a gradient to drop and opens up the stream channel width. This being shot from the Newhalem campground bridge over the Skagit River, just below Newhalem. But a contrast in the channel pipe down here compared with the bypass reach. Substrate is much smaller. Channel's much more open. And the gradient much flatter here. This is at the mouth of Thornton Creek, which is about a mile and a half below Newhalem. Stream channel again is much, much wider down here. Substrate is considerably smaller than what was seen in the bypass reach.